Good evening, everyone. I'm Aisha. I've been into teaching since the last 16 years. And I have done my ECC Ed, which entitles me to teach the pre-primary children. After that, I taught in the primary with this qualification. But now the implementation of DEd has come in. I will be explaining what that means in the course of the presentation. And recently I did my BEd, and now I've moved on to teaching in the secondary level. So I begin with my presentation here. Welcome everyone. The education system in India has been witnessing a huge transition over the last few years. There's been the modern techniques are being adopted in schools. Many parents have transitioned to homeschooling. Their children, the system is working towards helping students from all backgrounds to get quality education and so much more. In fact, the education system in the entire world is one that never stops, but rather keeps evolving with newer methodologies and ideas. A big question when the parents have to enroll their children in the schools in India. India being a diverse country, when I speak about diversity, it's not only about religion, not only about culture, caste, creed, but here in terms of education, we have various boards to decide from. And it is definitely a task for the parents because you have several boards to decide from. To begin with, we have the CBSE, which is the Central Board of Secondary Education. Then we have the ICSE, which is the Indian Certificate for Secondary Education, State Board, SSC, and SSLC. Now, this differs from state to state. In Mumbai, where I belong to, we have the SSC, and SSLC is in a state like Karnataka, down south. Then we have the International Baccalaureate and the International General Certificate of Secondary Education. Now, as I have placed on record, each board has a focus. The CBSE focuses on science and math. ICSE focuses on all languages, and it's a little more tough, but this is not rote learning. They have hands-on experience as well. They focus on all subjects like science, math, art. The state board is more of a rote-based learning. And the IB has a very innovative curriculum. They have a blend of application and experimentation. And the IGCSE is a rigorously specialized English language curriculum. Considering all these boards, we have nearly 15 lakh schools across the country. In the structure of education, previously, or I could say till now, we followed a structure which was 10 plus 2 plus 3, which means it was 10 years of schooling, 2 years of high school, and 3 years of university. But in July 2020, this year, the education minister has come up with a new structure, which would be 5 plus 3 plus 3 plus 4, 5 years of foundation stage, which would be from 3 years of age to 8 years of age. The preparatory stage would be of 3 years, that is from age 8 to 11 years of age. The middle stage would be again 3 years, from age 11 to age 14. And the secondary stage would be 4 years, from age 14 to age 18. Now, this was mainly brought into a practice. It's not yet brought into practice, but this was thought of to get the foundation very strong. Because 10 years of schooling, people would enroll their children at 3 years and 4 years, 5 years. So we've had students of 3, 4, 5 sometimes in the same class. So their performance differs. So now there would be a better foundation, and that's why this planning has been thought of. It's not yet implemented. Probably post the lockdown and post the pandemic, this would be implemented soon. So when we think of primary school curriculum, it emphasizes on general education and covers basic subjects like reading, writing, arithmetic, and it's also supplemented by history, civic, geography, and general science. History, national level and international level history. Then in a week, we have about 45 periods. We have mostly working for 5 days and 40 minutes each period would last for. Then the school has to work for a minimum of 200 teaching days. Otherwise, they are going to be pulled up. While the academic year begins in different months in different states, mostly the academic year in some schools over here begin from March and end in Feb. And in some schools, they start in June and they end in April. But now they are going to plan a way where all the schools would start and end together. So this would aid in the 10 standard board exams. Coming to the teacher education and qualification, at the pre-primary level, early childcare education and administration is the ECCA degree which a teacher has to go through. This will be done after HSC. HSC is a 10 plus 2 level. Then for the primary teachers, they have to do a DED, that's Diploma in Education. This again is done after 12th standard. And at the secondary, if you want to teach from 7th standard onwards, then you have to do a Bachelor in Education. This will be done only after graduation in any discipline. But the subjects, your specialization subjects will be based on what you've taken for your graduation. Apart from educational qualification, a teacher has to have professional development as well. This improves not only the teacher's skills, but also it boosts the students' learning outcomes. Again, when you're talking about professional development, there's a formal setting and there's an informal setting. For the formal setting, we have conferences, courses, seminars, retreats, workshops. And in the informal setting, we have independent research, investigation, peer learning initiatives, and constructive chatting with colleagues. Now, especially in professional development in India, they have started inclusive education, wherein children with basic learning disabilities and if they've had any kind of deformalities, they have to go through a specific training where the teachers are given some kind of professional development. There is a department in most of the schools called SEN, S-E-N, which is Special Educational Needs, where there are special educators and counselors, and such students can be taken care of in those special setup. But they are allowed to sit with the other children in a normal classroom as well. The various teaching approaches and strategies, audiovisual supplements, flip method, where the audiovisual, of course, it helps in having puzzles or games and all of that as visuals. The flip method is where the teacher would give her responsibility of teaching to the child and make the child a little more responsible. So what the teacher does is she shares the material, the matter, what she's going to teach through a PPT, or she will email them, and the child has to make a presentation or their own notes, and they come and then they have a discussion and then they have a debate. All these things are taking place in the classroom. Role play, especially in subjects like history, where a child is also allowed to put in his or her own thought as to what the character would be like. Peer teaching. This really helps because sometimes some children are not good in one subject but are excellent in another subject, while some others may not be very good in one subject but are excellent in the other subject. So here they have a balance, so nobody feels inferior. Instead, they would help each other, and this helps a lot in the classroom teaching. And of course, through games, where it's a very fun way and it does not tax you with so much of studies and all. So it's a way of easing out the teaching learning process. Now for improving literacy level in India, the government has come up with a few schemes. Now, the primary school system has expanded over 5 lakh villages in India. There is a system called Sarva Shiksha Abhiyan, which is providing elementary education, basic education to all children in the age group of 6 to 14 years. Then for people who are below poverty line, for them, such schools provide midday meals to the children. So this encourages attendance and of course the retention of children and improves their nutritional status as well. There are certain camps, like back to camps, where it has been initiated to increase the enrollment in elementary education. There have been people who go door to door trying to bring the children out and get them to learn and study in schools. Of course, education is a basic necessity to any society.
Excuse me, Aisha, can you please wrap up in 1 minute? Because we will be beyond time otherwise. Thank you.
Sure, ma'am. So the role of teacher involves the character building of the taught apart from designing and implementation. And of course, a teacher plays an important role. And so thus the teaching profession is considered the noblest profession. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Aisha. Yes, thank you very much, Aisha, for the presentation. I think you gave a good overview of how primary education is in India. You talk about the qualifications, you talk about the different boards in India, 1.5 million schools across the country, which is quite a huge number compared to that in Mauritius. The structure of education, you talk about the 10-year schooling in Mauritius, which is, for us in primary is mostly the 9 years basic 9-year schooling. What I also like about the presentation, you talk about the dynamic nature of education in India, how it's continuously changing, which is a good thing because the curriculum is always dynamic in nature. You talk about primary school curriculum, about the professional development for teachers, which I think is very important in today's world, which help the teachers to promote the 21st century skills. Through the strategies that you showed, we could see that this allow teachers to promote the 21st century skills. And lastly, you talk about the SEND, special education needs. You talk about inclusive education, where the students are included within the normal classroom, which is not normally the case here in our country. And the last slide, you talk about role of teachers in character development, which I think is very important. The attitudes of the teacher determines a lot on the teaching and the learning process. Thank you very much, Aisha, for the presentation. Again, we are going to take all the questions at the end of all the presentations. Thank you very much.